inside, from the inside. Let praises rise from the inside, from the inside. Yeah, hallelujah. Let the incense rise up before him. Let the incense go up before him. Let the smoke, hallelujah, rise, rise before him. Rise before him. Rise before him. Yes, rise before him. Rise before him. Hallelujah. We bless you, Lord. We praise you, Lord. We praise you, Lord. We praise you. Come on. We praise your name. We praise your name. Lord, yes, Lord. Yes. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah. We praise you. We praise you. We praise you. We praise you. Hallelujah. 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 Yes, Lord. 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 We bless your name, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Remain standing. Remain standing if you would. Oh, hallelujah. Please turn your Bibles with me as you stand, and we will read hallelujah. 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 We praise your name, Father. We praise your holy name. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Malachi 3, and we'll read from verse 1. I'm reading from the King James Version, which reads, "Behold, I will send my messenger, and he shall prepare the way before me. And the Lord whom ye seek shall suddenly come to his temple. Even the messenger of the covenant, whom ye delight in, behold, he shall come, saith the Lord of hosts. But who may abide the day of his coming? And who shall stand when he appeareth? For he is like a refiner's fire, and like fuller's soap. And he shall sit as a refiner and purifier of silver. And he shall purify the sons of Levi and purge them as gold and silver, that they may offer unto the Lord an offering in righteousness. Then shall the offering of Judah and Jerusalem be pleasant unto the Lord.
as in the days of old, as in the former years. And I will come near to you to judgment, and I will be swift witness against the sorcerers, against the adulterers, against false swearers, against those that oppress the hireling in his wages, the widow and the fatherless, and that turn aside the stranger from his right, and fear not me, saith the Lord of hosts. Father, we thank you for your holy word. We thank you for the word that reaches to the innermost parts of our spirits, to the depths of our souls, and transforms us. And Father, we are renewed, we are saved, we are redeemed by your word. And we thank you for the word that has gone forth, Lord. It's already gone forth. Lord, you send your word to heal. You send your word to transform. You send your word to raise up. You send your word, my God, to give hope. And this evening we stand under the authority of your word. In the name of Jesus, amen. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of God. This text which we have read prophesies or speaks of the coming of the Messiah, who is Christ. But it also alludes to John the Baptist, who we heard of this morning in a very powerful sermon by Pastor Lloyd F. I thank God for the word. As we go into this text, I'd like to use for a topic, reduced to be empowered. Reduced to be empowered. And I'm going to come back to my text in a while in Malachi. But what do we mean by being empowered? Well, the word empowered is really a past tense. It's a past participle. Empowered means to give the authority or power to do something. Members are empowered in an organization to perform certain tasks. There's various levels of empowerment. In IT systems, there's various levels of authority, levels of access. It's impossible for you to gain access unless you are hacking. But there is a system that none of us can hack into. When we think of empowerment, we think of some synonyms: to authorize, to license, entitle, to permit, to allow, to warrant. I have a warrant. You have been empowered. You have been commissioned to delegate, certify. There are many other synonyms that we could use. But there are some characteristics of the empowered life that I think are significant for us. And for us to grasp a principle, the principle of reduction, before we are empowered. What do we mean by this? I bought a battery some time ago for a little scale that I carry with me. So when I want to ensure when I'm traveling that my luggage is not overweight. And so there's a little battery, the number CR22, I think it is. It's a little flat battery that you buy to insert and you put that in there. But unknown to me, when I bought this, I couldn't see that there was a very thin film over the battery that sealed it. And so I tried and I put the battery all kinds of ways, and I was thinking, I'm getting upset now. And they're thinking of doing all manner of things. They think, well, this battery I've bought, and it's useless. But the reality is, it was good. But something needed to be removed from it. There was an invisible film that prevented contact, proper contact being made. And so I resolved that one. And it made me think about this, that there is a principle of reduction before we can be empowered. Amen. Let me unpack that a little bit more. In the text which we have read, the metaphors are used of a refiner. A refiner is a part of a process where gold or silver, the ore has been found, O-R-E. There's a place for a gold mine or a silver mine, and it's found in its natural state. But for you to get the benefit, the beauty, and for it to have real value, let's say the intrinsic value that's contained in that gold or silver, it has to be processed. Stay with me. The same is true for iron. Iron ore, or aluminium, or most of the elements that we find in the earth. They're gathered from the earth. They have to be processed, but they have to be reduced in order for them to be empowered and to have the value that they are worth. Where are we going with this? And so when we read the gospel, or we read Malachi, when the messenger, when he is come, he will sit as a refiner of silver and gold. He will purify the sons of Levi. That is telling me that the leadership, come on, the leadership of his people, they would have to go through a process. But it's not just the leadership. Because if we read Peter, 1 Peter 2, verse 9, but you are a royal priesthood. So collectively, the church is the priesthood. The body of Christ is the priesthood of God. Now for us, that he has empowered, he has redeemed us. We were hewn, as it were, from the pits, from the rocks. We've been gathered like clay, as it were. But there is precious value inside of us. Hallelujah. Now for God to get and to draw the value that's within us, we would need to go through a process. For us to be empowered and to be worth the true value that is placed within us, we have to go, as it were, on a journey. This journey is not pleasant. It's a hard journey. Because when I think of gold or silver and how it has to be crushed and then placed, as it were, in a melting pot, and then the heat he's applied to that. The temperature is raised by several hundred degrees to ensure that it becomes molten. My God, it becomes molten. And when it becomes molten, it's still not finished because the refiner has to stay there in that heat, in that a condition that is difficult to ensure that he's stirring. And as he stirs, all the sediments, all the dirt and the parts that are not worthy to be there, it rises to the top. Amen. You see, when fire comes upon the gold, it reduces it. Oh God. Bless the name of the Lord. And so if we're going to be empowered, there is a process that we will have to go. go through the principle called reduction. Mm-hmm. You see, reduction to us may not seem to be pleasant, but it's necessary. It is a principle that I have observed from the beginning of time. I have observed how that God would use mankind. He would, as it were, bring them to a common denominator where man cannot take the glory. There is a tendency for us to want to claim authority, power. We want to claim that we are the ones that have achieved this. But the song said, all the glory must be to the Lord. Come on. And if we're going to fulfill the mission that he has given us, then clearly we must have to go through the process of reduction. Yeah. Let me go a little bit further into that. This morning, as the text was being read concerning John the Baptist, you see, John said in John 3 and verse 25, I think it is, he must increase. And I what? I must decrease. So in order for God to fulfill the mission, the mandate upon my life, I must go through the process of reduction. Oh God. Hallelujah. And so when the flesh says, no, 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 you can't go through that process. It's yes, 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 Lord. Yes, Lord, to your will. Yes, Lord, to your way. When the Spirit speaks to me, with my all heart, I agree. And my answer will be, yes, Lord, yes. Hallelujah. The principle of reduction. And so if God's going to use us, there needs to be capacity within us. So there has to be the drawing out of Tedroy Powell's ambitions. All my hopes, my plans, my selfish ambitions, he has to draw them out. So that he can fill me. Because if I'm full up of myself, if I'm full up of my own stuff, then there's no room for God to move within me as he chooses to move. The principle of reduction. Individually, it's true. We must be, as it were, humbled before him. Emptied before him. Before he can use us. In that same text in John chapter 3, it is said that God did not give the Spirit by measure to Jesus. Why did he not give the Spirit by measure to Jesus? Well, because he was prepared. He was the Lamb of God, the Lamb prepared from the foundation of the earth. So, and of course, he was within him, the Godhead resided. Because in him was the fullness of the Godhead. He was within it. But to us who are mortals, human beings struggling with the tension of humanity and divinity, you see, as humanity decreases, he gives us another measure. Amen. Hallelujah. So each time we're in the refiner's pot and the temperature is turned up, and some of the debris and the sediments that shouldn't be there, God takes them out. Then you know what? He adds some of his goodness. Oh, God. Oh, hallelujah. So when he says, Simon, Simon, the devil has desired to sift you as wheat. You see, he had to go through his process of reduction. You see, you can't run from reduction. If God's going to use you, then you'll have to get to the place where all of me would have to be emptied. Empty me, Lord. Come on. Empty me, Lord. Empty me, Lord. Empty me, Lord. Empty me, Lord. Hallelujah. God needs to empty us for him to be able to use us to the fullest extent. Empty me, Lord. There needs to be a cry. Empty me, Lord. scriptures state quite clearly, there are seven things that God hates. And I want to name one of them. It's pride. Or even a proud look. Oh God. But you see, God hates pride. And if the church or individuals get to the level where we become so inflated, God cannot empower us. Oh Lord. A proud heart, a scornful look. God cannot empower me, empower the church, if we are full of ourselves. He has to take us to the place where we can be led by Him. Oh, hallelujah. Or even to the millennial kingdom that's typified, and the little child shall lead them. Church needs to get to that place. The principle of reduction. When you think about this, I thought about Gideon's army. I'm cutting this up. I thought about Gideon's army. And I thought, well, when Gideon, 32,000 were there. 32,000. And God called Gideon. And he wanted to use them. He wanted to defeat the Midianites. The trouble is, God said, Gideon, there are too many. There needs to be a reduction. What's the word?
Reduction.
Because there are too many among you that are fearful. The scripture uses the word fearful and afraid. Well, literally, it means they are fearful and trembling. Literally, that was what it meant. So, Gideon, I want you to put out an email. Come on, talk to me. I want you to telegraph to each of these. But if you are afraid, I want you to go home. Because God wants to defeat the Midianites. He wants to defeat our enemies. Oh God. But in order for Him to do it, there needs to be a reduction. Say reduction. Because we think that we can do it with the great numbers. Yes, we think down the road they have got 10,000 or a 50,000 or a 30,000 church. Come on. And we think it's the numbers that really count. And while on some measure that seems quite impressive, but the truth is, what is God saying to us? What is God really saying to us? Gideon, there needs to be a reduction. So when that circular went out, there were those who were glad to receive it. 22,000. Just imagine. 22,000. But God turned to Gideon and said, no, there's still too many. See, when God wants to work, flesh hinders. Flesh gets in the way. Flesh is a barrier. Flesh is an obstacle. Pride is an obstacle. So He has to take us through another process to reduce us. I want you to know that some of the things maybe that we have been through to reduce us is to test us. God wants to test us, to prove us, to see whether we are really His or not. Maybe. So Gideon took, God gave him instructions. Take them, Gideon. Take them down to the waters. Oh God. Sometimes we have to be taken to places that maybe you haven't dreamt of. But if you're going to be empowered, if you're going to be an overcomer, a conqueror, we have to do what God requires us to do. Sometimes you may be asked to do some things that I never imagined I was going to do this, but they went down to the waters. Lord, bring us, take us aside and use us as you will. Lord, bring your church to a place where we can find you. You see, oftentimes we are caught in the roots and the ruts of our mind,
thinking that God doesn't work in a particular way. But I want to tell you today, if God is going to use a people, we have got to learn to listen to his voice. The old principle of leaders being reduced. You know, Gideon, in chapter 6, in his dialogue with God, Gideon says, and Ali and I, we prayed this prayer. Gideon says, Lord, wherewith shall it be known that I have been in the presence of God? Wherewith shall it be known, chapter 6 and verse 17, that the Lord has spoken to me? Oh God. You see, leaders, we need to have that divine connectivity. When we are divinely connected, there cannot be anything between us and God. When he speaks, we hear, we move. And even though they may not like the way you dress, or the way you say it, or even your mannerisms, because you won't find a school or a college that will actually empower you to that level, it takes the hand of the Almighty God to rest upon you. Oh, hallelujah. And you say like Ezekiel, the hand of the Lord was upon me, for he carried me out in the spirit, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. The hand of God needs to rest upon our sons, upon our daughters. The hand of God needs to be on this church. When God's hand rests upon us, he'll bring us to places that hitherto you have not imagined. Pastor and congregation, you see the regular services, God will break that cycle. God will break that cycle. And there will be a church that listens and hears. Pastor, he's hearing from God. Oh, we had service in the park this morning. Wow, we had service in the park. We went down the bus shelter and we had service. You see, because God is speaking, there has to be a principle of reduction before we can be empowered. Oh Lord, hear us. Hallelujah. When we hear from him, when we hear from him, we will move. Hallelujah. I know that we, to an extent, we have been institutionalized. And I've been institutionalized to a degree. But I want to pray God to break the straitjacket of institutionalization. I want to break that straitjacket. So when the spirit, when the anointing comes upon us, hallelujah, it destroys the yoke. When the anointing comes upon us, we destroy the protocols. When the anointing comes upon us, we obey him. We hear his voice. We say, yes, Lord, speak, thy servant heareth. Lord, speak, your children hear. Park. We went down the bus shelter and we had service. You see, because God is speaking, there has to be a principle of reduction before we can be empowered. Oh, Lord, hear us. Hallelujah. When we hear from him, when we hear from him, we will move. Hallelujah. I know that we, to an extent, we have been institutionalized. And I've been institutionalized to a degree. But I want to pray God to break the straitjacket of institutionalization. I want to break that straitjacket. So when the spirit, when the anointing comes upon us, hallelujah, it destroys the yoke. When the anointing comes upon us, we destroy the protocols. When the anointing comes upon us, we obey him. We hear his voice. We say, yes, Lord, speak, thy servant heareth. Lord, speak, your children hear. We need to be a church that's listening. A church that's positioned to listen. A church that's positioned to hear from God. God, hear us to hear from you. God, help us to hear your voice. Somebody bless God. Hallelujah. 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 Come on. Reduction. My process of reduction. Lord, I need to hear from you. I need to hear from you. Hallelujah. Take us to the waters, Lord. Take us to the waters. Region 1 North. Are you ready to go to the waters? Oh, I ain't gonna follow Pastor Harold. We're not gonna follow Pastor Gloria. But God said, go to the waters. God said, go to the waters. Hallelujah. If it's the waters, we have to go to the waters. But Pastor, what, go to the waters? There can't be no argument. Let's go to the waters. God wants to prove us. Complainers, the spirit of complaining, we set fire to the spirit of complaining, fire to the spirit of grumbling and complaining and undermining. There are many underminers, complainers, mourners, grumblers in the name of Jesus, but we set fire, fire, the refiner's fire. Come on. The spirit of complaining, grumbling. Some pastors feel intimidated. Some leaders feel intimidated. Can't lead. What will the people say? What will the people say? The truth is, oftentimes we're worried about our jobs than we are about what God says. That's the truth. Yes, because we want to seem to fit the mold. Fit the mold, fill the patterns. But it's God's pattern that's important. It's God's hand that's important. Gideon obeyed. He was Gideon. When you think of the old nation, listen, when you read chapter 6, you'll see that Israel, the nation, they were threshing wheat. Where? In a cave. Who threshes wheat in a cave? People who are afraid and in hiding. Because the Midianites knew when it was harvest time. There are some spirits that gather around the church of God of prophecy. I want to preach this message like I want to preach it. Oh God. There's some spirits that gather. You know, there's territorial spirits over every city. There are some spirits that can be identified over every city. But just like over every church, there are some spirits. There are some dominant spirits. But in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we come against the dark spirits, the spirits that wants to hold God's people back, and we are breaking forth. We are breaking forth in the name of Jesus. We are breaking forth through our obedience in the name of Jesus. We are breaking forth. Not afraid. Not afraid. Pastors that are here, stand. Come on. Mama Kulobo Shanda. Pastors that are here, stand. Lela Mama Kulobo Shanda. Mama Kulobo Shanda. You need to stand and declare like Micah. Micah 5 and verse 8 says, truly, I am full of power. Mama Oshanda, truly I am full of power by the Spirit of the Lord to declare unto Jacob his transgression and to Israel his sin. God has filled you up with power. God has filled you up with power. Hallelujah. When the Holy Ghost comes upon you, when the Holy Spirit sits upon you, obey him in the name of Jesus. Obey him in the name of Jesus. Somebody bless the Lord. Glory to God. Hallelujah. The Midianites knew it was harvest time. God knows the work that you're doing. My God, those prayer meetings, we're only one or two. It's a, where's the church? Don't worry. When you get into those meetings, heaven will come down. The glory of God will come down. God's anointing will cover you. Go into the presence of God. Go in, go in, go in. Go into the presence of God. Let God anoint you. Worship ministers, church, get with your pastors. Let God anoint you with a fresh anointing. He is empowering you, but you must first have to go via the way of the cross. Lord, Lord, we bless your name. You may be seated, pastors. Lord, I'm not going to preach anything near the notes I had. But listen, Jesus was ultimately the role model for us. Philippians 2 summarizes it. You see, reduction for empowerment. Turn to Philippians 2. Let this mind. Let's pause. Let this mind be in you, which also was. Oh, hallelujah. Let this mind be in you. We send the prophetic word to drive away every barrier, every obstacle. Let this mind be in you, which also was in Christ Jesus. Send that word. Milakobo Shanda. The word is mighty to the pulling down of stronghold, the casting down of imagination. Let this mind. 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 I command it in the name of Jesus. Let this mind. Put your hands on your head. Come on. It's a prayer. Let this mind. Let this mind. Let this mind be in me. Hallelujah. Let this mind be in me. Hallelujah. Which also was in Christ Jesus. In the name of Jesus, pray it again. Let this mind be in me, which also was in Christ Jesus. We are declaring that word. Declaring that word. The prophetic word over your life, over your path. You're clearing that path. If any negatives in our mind, we are clearing them. Let this mind, let this mind, the renewed mind, the regenerated mind, the sound mind. This mind. Hallelujah. This mind. This mind. Every man, every woman, every boy, every girl in this place, with this mind. The battleground for the mind. The battleground for the mind. We seize authority today by the blood of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It also was in Christ Jesus. And listen, next verse says, who being in the form of God. Who being in the form of God. Listen, he was God himself. God himself. In the form of God. He says, thought it not robbery to be equal with God. but what made himself. Ain't no preacher. I'm no teacher. No pastor. No good singer. No reputation. How many of you are willing to go with that reputation? I hear that he can preach, you know. No reputation. I hear he can teach. No reputation. No badge. No chariots and runners before the chariots announcing your coming. No reputation. The principle of reduction. No reputation. Call sister, no reputation. God wants to use you. Brother, no reputation. God wants to use you. Hallelujah. The word said he emptied himself. Come on. The emptying of yourself. Literally, he took off the robe of glory. Derobed himself. Laid it down. I'm going to step down and become flesh like Tedroy Powell. I become flesh like Linton Nelson. Lord. But listen, that wasn't enough. Isaiah said he was numbered with the transgressors. In other words, he had a prison number on his back. Prisoner number. You give him a number. No reputation. The principle of reduction is the gateway to empowerment. Hallelujah. I feel the holy hush of the Spirit in this place. Principle of reduction is the gateway to empowerment. When he made himself of no reputation, what did he do? And what? And took upon himself the form of a bishop. A cardinal, a deacon, a deaconess. You look like a good deaconess. No, took upon himself the form of a servant. And the word servant there is not the posh word that we use as in Downton Abbey, the Downton Abbey servants. No. This is a bond slave. One who has had his ears pierced. Oh, don't go there. Because you've pledged loyalty to the King of Kings. And so you publicly pierced your ears. That's the Old Testament principle. To say that you're under his servanthood. So being found what? In fashion what? As a man. He what? Humbled himself. Humbled himself. Region 1 North, Church of God of Prophecy. We have to humble ourselves. To what level? To a servant. And became obedient. Unto what? Even what? So through the cross. So when we have communion, when we have communion and we sit together, don't miss communion service again. Don't miss communion again. Sit together as a church, symbolizing the cross, the death of Jesus Christ. It's the gateway to power. It symbolizes power. Matter of fact, it's not symbolizing, it is power. Even the death of the cross. Recently, we began a new phase by having one bread. One bread that we shared in our meeting on the 21st. 21st of October. And that bread was divided, sent to all the regions, the local churches. So when we partake of communion, it's one bread. United for purpose. Church, that's where we are. We intend to do that. We intend to do that again. Because the message needs to get home. When we assemble, as it were, at the foot of the cross, we have humbled ourselves to the point of death, even the death of the cross. We are getting ourselves positioned by the river, like Gideon's 3,000 that went down to the river. Gideon, those that lapped the water. See, I'm skipping from one old to new. You stay with me. You see, when those who knelt down and they lapped water like a dog, and there were those who stooped down, scooped up the water, there was a difference. The one was alert, the other was not, because their focus was purely. Their purpose was satisfying themselves. And so if you're satisfying yourself, you still need reduction. You're not ready yet. And that's why you were sent home. That's why they were sent home. Because they were not ready yet. But the 300 that stopped, they were alert because they were fighting men. And by 300, they had the victory. By 300, they overcame. They drove out the Midianites. And the victory was in the name of the Lord. The victory was in the name of the Lord. So when you do it as God wants you to do, you've gone through your reduction. Maybe in your local church, your cell group, or wherever it is, if you've gone through the reduction, God will not destroy you. Because the victory is in the name of the Lord. And listen, what does the text say? He humbled himself to the death of the cross. Wherefore? Oh God, wherefore? Come on, have you got to your wherefore yet? As a result of... as a result of this, God hath what? Highly exalted. Oh, hallelujah. Highly exalted. Not a little exaltation. Not just a little promotion. Not just exaltation, but highly exalted him. And what? Not just the exaltation. Oh, God. But has given him a name. Oh, hallelujah. Not just any name. A name that is above what? Above what? Above the Pope? Above the Pope? Above the Cardinals? Oh, God. Above the Prophet? Above the Apostle? Yes. A name that is above every name. So what? That at the... stand with me. At the name of... what will happen? Every knee? The rich man? The poor? What about the queens? What about the kings? What about the presidents? What about the billionaires? Every knee shall bow. Every knee shall bow. Come on. And what will happen? Oh God. Every tongue. Every tongue. Right now, you can't get a word out of some people in worship. Can't get a word. Can't get a word. Try as hard as you can. But the time is coming. The time is coming. When every tongue will confess that who? That who? I can't hear you good. What's his name? Jesus who? Jesus Christ. The healer, Deliverer.
Yes.
What's his name?
Jesus.
Your Savior.
Yes.
Your Redeemer.
Yes.
What's his name?
Jesus.
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 Jesus. Jesus. Jesus. Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That at the name of Jesus, hallelujah, every knee, we're coming into prayer time, every knee, but note, even our Savior went through the principle of reduction. What do you tell John the Baptist? For it becometh us to fulfill what? All righteousness. Though he were a son, yet learned he what? Learned he obedience. Obedience is not the conceptual knowledge that's taught. It has to be experienced before it's caught. Can I say that again? You see, obedience cannot be taught in your seminaries or your universities. It has to come through experience, experiential knowledge, not the conceptual theoretical knowledge of obedience. I could write a thesis on that of 100,000 words, and it still wouldn't get me to heaven. Except I had the experience. My God, though he were a son, yet learned he obedience through the things which he suffered. The principle of reduction is the gateway to empowerment. I want you to come with me at the altar. Whatever your situation is, if you need to be raised another measure of the Spirit, don't think that once is enough. Ephesians 5:18. Be not drunken with wine. Be not drunken with wine, wherein is excess, but be filled. Be filled and keep on being filled. That's literally the Greek translation in that text. When was the last time you had another measure of the Spirit? We're finishing now. We won't be here much longer. Another 5-10 minutes max. Hallelujah. Fire! 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 Oh God. Another measure, Lord. But for you to get that other measure, the next measure, another level of reduction. Another level of reduction, another measure of his Spirit. Another level of reduction, another measure of his Spirit. When was the last time you openly disobeyed your leader, your cell group leader, your worship team leader? Oh, she's only a worship team leader. It's your leader. It's your pastor. Oh, he's only a man. It's your leader. It's like disobedience is as treated as nothing. Nothing. Stubbornness, nothing. But you see, that's almost like witchcraft. Stubbornness is like witchcraft, like a curse that's binding. But in the name of Jesus, we said fire to it. Oh God. This altar should be full up of people. Should be full up of people. Another measure. Another measure. Oh, okay. 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 So I get it. Everybody here is full up and there's no more capacity for another measure. Okay. Okay, my God, another level of reduction, another measure of the Spirit, Another level of reduction. Another measure of the Spirit. Fire, Lord. He can sit as a refiner. A refiner, refiner, refine, refine, refine. Refine the church. Refine the leadership. Refine us, God. Refine us. Refine us, Lord. Radababo shanda labo shanda. Irabo shanda labo sanda. Another measure. Irabo shanda la momosa. Irabo shanda. In the spirit we break, we break. We break, we break. Every chain in the name of Jesus. Every fetter in the name of Jesus. Lord, help me. Another measure, another level of submission. To submit my will, my stubborn will. God, I yield it to you. I yield it to you. I yield it to you, God. Jesus. Lord, I bless your name. Jesus, I bless your name. I praise your name, Lord. Yes, God. Yes. Yes. That's the song. That's the song. Yes. Come across. Bring it across. Yes. Yes. Bring it across. Release that song. Yes, Lord.
As we stand on your word.
Yes. In the name of Jesus. In the precious name of Jesus. Lord, release, Lord. Release, Lord. Another measure of your spirit upon your sons and your daughters, Lord.